guys, welcome to the DMX Show. I'm your host Shane. This is the Tech Blog where we talk about Google, Android, all things that are tech related, plus things that I find interesting. Some of you may have heard that yesterday YouTube celebrated its 7-year anniversary of the first ever video that was uploaded to its servers. That's an awesome thing. YouTube has really grown over the past 7 years. YouTube used to be the place where you went to find videos of cute kittens or guys getting kicked in the nat or any other number of funny, hilarious things just to kill time. YouTube has matured over the years. It's now a place where content creators come and upload things that they've spent tons of time on and spent lots of money on producing. There's so much good content here. This YouTube in general could actually, and it often does, compete with broadcast networks and cable networks. I know that YouTube definitely has more of my time than many of the cable networks or the big broadcast networks. In fact, this is the trend. People are spending more of their time on YouTube than they are on television or internet TV in general. Some people are even cutting the cord. YouTube has grown astronomically since the very first video that was uploaded. To put it in perspective, more than 60 hours of video are uploaded every minute, 1 hour of video per second. More video is uploaded in a month than ABC, NBC, or CBS put together and produced in 60 years of their existence. In 2011, YouTube had more than 1 trillion views, and that's 140 views per person on the entire earth. More than 4 billion videos are viewed every day. More than 3 billion hours of YouTube are watched every week. Now that's astronomical. My question is, can you guys live without YouTube? I myself feel like I couldn't live without YouTube. It's something that I go to every day. I really started out using YouTube to gather guides and tutorials of how to do things like change out a fan in the house, change out a light switch, unclog a drain, replace the handle of the toilet. As you can tell, I'm not a handyman, and that's really where I got my start on YouTube, is just going and finding guides on how to fix my house. What are your experiences? How did you start using YouTube? Why is YouTube so important to you? Why are you celebrating this 7th anniversary? Moving forward, Facebook has reached 901 million users. These are not just users that have signed up. Facebook claims that these 901 million users are active monthly users. So that means that they get on Facebook at least once a month to do something on Facebook, whether it be looking at a friend's profile or checking their notifications, reading their inbox, posting something on somebody's wall. These are people that have actually visited the site, and not just visited the site, but use Facebook in a month. So to put that in perspective, 901 million users, that's 1/7 of the world's population. In 2010, there were less than 7 billion people in the entire world. Now, personally, I kind of felt like over the past year, Facebook was waning. It was losing popularity. I've heard a lot of people, I know that it's the new popular thing to say, you know, I've left Facebook, I don't use Facebook, Facebook's old news. I've heard plenty of people say that, but the truth is, even myself, I don't use Facebook on a daily basis, but I do go at least once a month, in my case, at least once a week, to check on my notifications, to check up on family, to check up on friends. It's just so easy to keep in contact with people that I otherwise would not even talk to on a regular basis. It's also something that I feel obligated to do. I feel like I have to be on Facebook because everybody else is on Facebook. They kind of suck me in like that. What are your experiences? Do you guys use Facebook on a regular basis? Is this something that you feel like will have strong growth? Eventually, Facebook is going to run out of people who can use their services. I mean, they already have 1/7 of the world's population, so eventually the people will just plain run out. They are still growing at a rapid pace. In fact, they should reach 1 billion users by August of this year. Their IPO had them valued at $100 billion, so that's $100 for every one of their users. So you guys, according to the IPO, you guys are worth at least $100 each. So what are your thoughts? Are you looking forward to this stock becoming public? Will you be an investor? I will not be an investor. I still kind of feel like it only has one way to go, and that's down. I feel like it has reached its maximum potential unless they take over the world. Who knows? Maybe Facebook is Skynet. I really don't know. What are your thoughts? Is Facebook Skynet? Are they going to take over the world? Can they gain any more popularity than they already have? Can they become even bigger than they have already become? Or is the only way they can go down? Leave your comments below. Be sure to click on that subscribe button. Give this video a big thumbs up and share with your friends. Guys, I appreciate it. I'll see you in the next one.